Hello and welcome, dear children, to the English online class. Today we are continuing with the same story, a very interesting story in fact, The Fire in the Forest. Means this story gives us a very good moral, a value about the life, right? So today I'm here to continue again with the same page number 94 and 95 from a Cambridge course book. Before going to the story, let us understand what are the learning objectives of the story. So over here we learn and understand the survival of a brave hen. Hen means the female deer and its baby form, right? The brave, right? This brave is what? My adjective describing about the female deer. Right? So how she tried her best to save her baby. The reason why? Because that forest was caught, broke out in the fire. And this fire happened because of the negligence of the man. Okay? And that means it was maybe that there were a man who was smoking a cigarette, and the flame, because of that flame, because of that, the forest was caught in the fire. Okay, so and we will learn the close relationship between a mother and a child, whether it's a human or an animal. The love over here of seen of the mother for his baby. Okay, we will appreciate the tale, the story about survival of a mother and his form in the wild life. उस घने जंगल में आग लगने के कारण किस तरह से हिरण माँ ने अपने इस बच्चे को बचाया, right? So the summary says of the story that the author has conveyed how animals in the forest fight for the survival demands. Okay. This forest was caught and surrounded by the fire. So every animals were trying to save themselves from this fire. So and this fire was broke out because the negligence of a man. Okay? And how? A man took out the last drop of the cigarette and dropped it on the path in the forest. Okay? Maybe he was, maybe the man was smoking, and what he did, he just threw the cigarette in the forest, and then suddenly, because of that cigarette, the whole forest was caught or was surrounded by the fire. And then the deer who had just delivered a baby, okay, a newborn baby, she tried her best to save the life of the baby. And also the other animals like tiger and other animals were also running, they were also running to save their life and their babies. Correct? In the forest, there were in that forest, there were forest department who were trying to control the fire. Okay, but there was a deer there that she was away from herd. Herd we heard is a collective noun. Okay, so she gave a baby, delivered a baby, and she could realize, she could understand that there is something wrong, something is there wrong in this, and she could see the smoke of it. Now page number 95 we'll start with. Okay, he was so slow, so weak and disobedient too. He kept sinking down, exhausted, refusing to get up again. He means the baby, the fawn, okay. He was, the baby was newborn, had no strength in body to rise and get up. Okay. So she forced her baby on the rough bites, nipping his soft flesh. Okay. Biting, trying to bite, trying to means she was trying her baby to make a stand so that they can run away from this fire. Okay. But now the roar of the furnace was close behind. Means the fire that was caught in the forest, they were very close to it. Terror beat in the fawn's body. Terror means now the baby can also smell and feel that this fire that was caught in the forest was really harmful and dangerous for them. So what he did, he staggered and fell down, could not get up. Means that baby was trying to get up. Okay, but newborn baby, there was no strength. Okay, so anyhow, the mother was trying to wake him up, make him stand, but could not do that. And just then the hind saw smoke and heard of her, it was still behind them. And she could see that the fire was very near to them. Okay. Then she knew they were caught just the way you could be caught between the two hunting panthers. It means the fire was from both the sides, from both directions, and this dear mother and baby was in the center. So from both directions, the fire was close to them. Her fawn, by panting on the earth, stretched out, sparks were falling all around. So the sparks, the flames could be seen all around the forest, everywhere, and she was, the baby and the mother was surrounded by the fire. Okay, and she still did not give it up. She still was, she was running, searching for survival so that she can save at least her baby, right? His flesh shivered when they fell on him. He did not get up. She could see the blaze now roaring up the street of fire exploding bamboo. Means, as you can see in this picture, page number 96, there are flames. You can see the flames. The forest is totally surrounded by the fire, and you can see the smokes, right? So, and this was a big terror for both the mother and the baby. But she want the baby, the hind, the female deer wanted that at least she could save her baby from this, okay, situation. With smoke, anxious eyes and nostrils, they panicked on to and fro, sought green rushes and sense knocked out of them by terror. So it was totally a terror situation for the deer hind. Okay. Suddenly they opened up before the dried river dwelt, and there was a small river over there in the forest. So she wanted that anyhow she could manage to cross this river so that at least she can save the life of the baby. And this mother, what she did, when she reached too near to that river, okay, she pushed her fawn baby into the edge of the water, and she was watching her baby so that she could cross, that the baby could cross the river and can save the life. Even she saw, the dear mother saw, there were other animals who also wanted to save themselves and their babies from this disaster. Okay, disasters created or done by the human beings, right? And due to this fire, many animals, their homes, many animals, they died, okay, of this nonsense, of this negligence created by the human beings. But above them the fire rained and the whole tree healed over, blazing and fell around, saved his head. So this fire that was all over the forest, at last the cool breeze blew, the water coursed, the air was full of choking smoke. So there was smoke, could be seen all over the forest and jungle, the wildlife. The fawn was not strong enough to move yet, so he and his mother stayed there while their bones cooled in the pool drinking the rapid fire. So the mother, dear mother, she also crossed the river, with her baby, as we can see in this picture, that how she, the deer and the baby, they are crossing this river, and at last the mother she saved her baby from this big disaster that happened in the jungle, in the forest, and they moved into the unburned forest and presently joined the herd again. So she was lucky enough, she was with her efforts of the dear mother, she saved the newborn baby who was just born. And then this dear mother again joined the herd, the group of the deer, and then she stayed with them, right? So this story, what we have said, that how the mother, as I said, mother love for the baby is endless, right? We cannot compare the love of the mother, right? As we cannot measure the depth of the ocean, in the same way we cannot compare the love of the mother, right? No matter, even sometimes we are sick, we are not well, but she is there always to protect us, right? So that's why we should always love and respect our parents. We should always listen to them, obey them. We shouldn't argue with our parents, right? So because of them we are here. We know that we should understand the importance of parents, right? So here we can see how the animal mother deer tried her best, gave her full effort to save the baby, the fawn. So this is the chapter, and the notes already given to you in the document PDF. Do copy the notes, and go through the story, read it, and complete the work. Thank you, and see you in the next class.